Yesterday, Nancy Pelosi, a true champion of women, defended John Conyers over claims of sexual harassment. She was awful.
John Conyers is an icon in our country. He has done a great deal to protect women, Violence Against Women Act, which the right wing is now quoting me as praising him for his work on that, and he did great work on that.
Ah, yes, the icon clause, in which public service excuses private behavior. I call it the pig pass. The more progressive you are, the more disgusting you can be. Champion publicly, harass privately. Or if you're Ted Kennedy, Harvey Weinstein, or Bill Clinton, not so privately. Apparently, Conyers would show up to a meeting in his underwear. Strange, but maybe it was casual Friday. But while Nancy wants due process for Conyers, she's not behind it for private citizens. She supported Title IX, which allows schools, not the law, to handle rape cases. Odd, we'd never expect a college to settle a murder rap. It makes no sense. Anyway, it's not like defending bad behavior is new for Nancy.
Why the silence when there have been these allegations, serious ones, about President Clinton?
Well, I'd like to say that I think that the women of America are speaking out about what they think about this whole situation. And the women of America are just like other Americans in that they value fairness, they value privacy, and do not want to see a person with uncontrolled power, uncontrolled time, uncontrolled, unlimited money investigating the president of the United States.
I'll say this, at least she's consistent in her hypocrisy. For whom she defends is always based on politics. If the harasser's on your team, you soften your stance. It happens on the left, and now it's on the right. But the left made it an art form. No wonder Alabamans ignore the media about Roy Moore. But the real scandal, let's call that Congregate. That's where your money is being used to settle cases involving politicians' misconduct. Congregate. How is this okay? And how did the media miss Congregate? 234 incidences in Congress covered up by $17 million in taxpayer money could be one of the biggest stories in decades. And it flew right under our radar. But not anymore. No wonder Nancy looks so nervous or excited. I mean, I can never tell. where to start? So much here. Is this a big deal, Congregate?
I like Congregate. I think that everyone should hashtag that right now and give you full credit.
I know, even though maybe I might have stolen it from a celebrity friend of mine.
When I saw the Nancy Pelosi interview on Meet the Press, I thought it was communications malpractice because, yeah. Like, when your boss is going to go on a Sunday show, you get together and you prep.
Yes.
And you think about what are all the possible questions that are going to be, that we are going to get. This was obviously going to be one of them. So I have to ask, like, was this planned?
Yeah.
Like, or was this, and when she is practicing the answer, does it not occur to anybody that this sounds really bad?
Yeah. Kimberly, how do you think she did there? I mean, she's done it before. At least she's consistent.
Yeah, maybe the older Cliff was more compelling. But, you know, it's a double standard, the hypocrisy. Why does she even go out and say that? It's like they make excuses to say, oh, they're champion of women's rights before, the iconic figure. That doesn't give you a pass for inappropriate behavior or sexual assault or misconduct or sexual harassment. So, you know, but you see people making excuses saying, well, he's older.
Yeah.
Now he didn't know what he was really doing, or it's not that sexy because he's older. And I mean, that also makes no sense to me.
No, it's a, Jesse, it's a problem, especially showing for working your underwear.
I thought it was pajamas.
I wouldn't know anything about that. So maybe somebody else here at the table do, Gutfeld. I think the Democrats have lost their moral authority on sexual harassment, not that they ever had any to begin with. I think that Pelosi played herself because she put power over principle. She's either too afraid of the Congressional Black Caucus, or she knows there's a ton of shoes that are about to drop on some of the other members of the Democratic Party, so she doesn't want zero tolerance because she's trying to retake back the House. The icon excuse, probably. The icon excuse, I think she's using icon a little too loosely there. The guy's a congressman. He's not Muhammad Ali. And there are other actual icons recently that have been taken down by sexual harassment that are a lot more iconic than John Conyers, and that excuse did not work for them either.
We won't mention their names.
She's also using the Harvey Weinstein and Bill Clinton excuse, yeah, which is undermine the credibility of the women,
right,
and say that because this guy has fought for progressive causes and they're going to take on the NRA, that you have to side with them. But just because you vote with Nancy doesn't give you a license to get handsy. And then you have the part where Conyers now is being denied due process. Who's denying John Conyers due process? It's not like he's the victim here.
Well,
he's going to go to an ethics investigation.
But he settled he already had a settlement in his office.
Exactly.
I mean, that's how he decided to do the due process.
That was the due process.
That was his choice.
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, go ahead.
False flag.
I want to get Juan in here. This congregate, which will be bigger than Watergate.
It's
a big deal. This is a cover. I mean, should they make all of this transparent and let everybody know what these cases were? Or is this going to be a nightmare?
I think that'd be a nightmare. I think there is some need for confidentiality. The thing is, it's got to be a publicly established process so everybody knows there is some way that you can come to the table and say there's a problem with your employer or colleague and make it and get some sense of, you know, resolution to the problem. But I just think I'm listening to you guys and I'm just like, wow.
Always.
So this is how you're handling Roy Moore. You're going to accuse the Democrats of hypocrisy.
Wait, what?
When I heard from Nancy Pelosi yesterday, I think Dana's on track. She didn't look great. But here's what she said. No matter about the legacy, there is no license for bad behavior in terms of sexual harassment and zero tolerance. That's from Nancy Pelosi. I don't hear that from you guys. Instead, you're busy trying to make the case that Nancy Pelosi is making excuse for him.
She did.
She didn't. What she said, and the worst, let me just, I'll weaken my own argument. The worst that she said was, I don't know who these women are, when in fact, part of the deal was that the women would not be public with their allegations.
I mean, you did weaken your argument strongly just there.
I did, because I want everything on the table. But I must say that she did not say what you said. She said zero tolerance. And by the way, Jesse,
what is zero tolerance mean?
Jesse, let me just tell you something. That guy is an icon. John Conyers, not only in terms of what he did as a member of Congress on the Title IX, other issues that she was talking about, but establishing the Congressional Black Caucus.
I'm not putting
Detroit
John Conyers down. I am saying, if you go out in the street and ask anybody who John Conyers is, no one knows who he is.
That's not
iconic.
I'm sorry. Maybe it's your age, but John Conyers is pretty well known in Washington and in Michigan.
Well,
I don't think there's any
question.
Just because
people know him in Washington doesn't know the
Michigan.
Rest of the country.
Well, I agree. But I don't
still... still no excuse.
You know what? Yeah, more people wouldn't know who Nancy Pelosi is if you asked me. Here's a picture. Who's this?
I consider myself an icon.
Right. Well, you are. You're my icon.
I am. You are my icon as well. Can we roll this? So Al Franken spoke today against this wonderful black background.
Which weird lighting.
It was like he was floating in space.
Yeah, just his head.
Yes.
Let's look.
Anyway, let's take a look.
If you had, you know, asked me 2 weeks ago, would any woman come forward with an allegation like this, I would have said no. And so I cannot speculate. This has been a shock, and it's been extremely humbling. I am embarrassed. I feel ashamed. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start my job. I'm going to go back to work.
You know, as much as I want to make fun of him and stuff, I have to say, I saw somebody that is overwhelmed by circumstance. When he said, if you had asked me 2 weeks that this would happen, I never would have seen this coming, which means he saw this blanket of offensive behavior of grabbing people as part of a shtick, and that he's like completely overwhelmed. I honestly do kind of sense contrition. Is that how you say it?
Contrition.
Contrite, but
you congregate. Can say
congregate.
I'm good with some things, bad with others. We'll be right back.
So I talked to a couple staffers that were watching it, and they said they were young women, and they said they found it to be totally insincere. Mm-hmm. Now, I think that for him, he probably was mustering up as much sincerity as he could because he never thought this was a problem.
Right.
So like 2 weeks ago, he never would have thought that he would have been in the same category as Harvey Weinstein.
Right.
Or Roy Moore, or whoever else it might be. But it's different for me, especially watching him, is he says, I'm sorry, I'm embarrassed, and I'm ashamed, and I'm going back to work. The difference with the private sector is that if you say, I'm sorry, I'm ashamed, and they're like, okay, you're still fired.
Yeah.
And you go.
That's what the difference is. Now, the Democrats have set something up where if you're Conyers and you say, I deny it, they believe you. Or if you're this guy in Minnesota, you say, I apologize, then you're forgiven. So the Democrats can have it either way, both ways, and they're still absolved.
Jesse, this is news to me. I believe that Conyers is now subject to an ethics investigation.
Wait, I bet Conyers is shaking in his shoes.
Well, I'm just saying.
What happened? He's not wearing shoes.
He denied the allegation. There's an investigation. This is like you guys are trying to set Democrats up as straw men who, whenever it's a Democrat, they excuse sexual harassment.
Ron, I'm just holding you guys to the same standards that you guys said.
Let me just tell you something.
You said zero tolerance.
Zero tolerance.
You said you believe every single woman that comes forward, and now they've settled multiple harassment lawsuits. There's photographic evidence, and now all of a sudden, ethics investigation. That's toothless.
Jesse, stop. Hold on. But, Jesse, if you look at Harvey Weinstein, Kevin Spacey, Bill Cosby, I could go on. I don't see Democrats defending these folks. I see Democrats saying there's a problem here.
And yet,
when you come to Roy Moore...
And all those guys lost their jobs and lost their careers, but their colleagues haven't.
Okay, let me draw a distinction here with Kimberly. The difference, I see it differently than Juan, between the Republicans and the Democrats. Roy Moore is actually running against Mitch McConnell. And Franken and Conyers are actually backed by their party. So... it's the Republicans who are actually being noble about this, right?
The establishment.
They want Moore to step aside.
Oh, yeah. Is that what President Trump said?
No, but McConnell, we just saw John Thune. There's no lockstep in the Republican Party. As you can tell here, there's lockstep in boxers.
But not with younger women in the Democratic
Party. They're mad at Nancy. Go ahead.
You call me again. I agree with you. And that's why, to me, it's perplexing, because the biggest sin was the first problem with Bill Clinton, where you saw Democrats, and they're still not even really that willing to call him out on his behavior, despite those women being brave, coming forward, telling their stories repeatedly, making fresh complaints at the time, physical evidence, et cetera, of injury, like with Juanita Broderick. And now you see the Democrat, wait a second. Conyers is iconic, so therefore get your Fruit of the Loom on, sit in your underwear, it's all good. Geraldo tried this with me the other night. He said,
what's that? In front of you?
Oh, my goodness.
What I meant on the air, on Hannity. And he said, Conyers, come on, he's older guy, it's not that sexy, sitting there in his under. I said, but that's not the standard. If he's David Beckham or not.
That is not the point.
Do you know what it is, right? Yeah. He's like, if it's an old guy, I don't think it was meant to be that way. And I was like, I don't think so.
If you use that excuse, it has to do with the mental faculties, saying he's not aware that his robe is open.
Well, that was something the New York Times just reported, and they said that he'd actually showed up in his robe on a number of occasions at public events.
So maybe it's something that isn't, maybe it's more sad than it is.
Well, he's 88.
Yeah.
This has been going on for years. He's been in Congress for 50 years.
He's the longest serving member right now. So he's an older person.
He's a senior guy. Just about this
issue on the NDAs and whether they should all be revealed and we should have total transparency. Sometimes NDAs are there to protect the victim. Mm-hmm. And I don't think that we should be out calling for all of them to be made public writ large and just say, rip the band-aid off because it's taxpayer dollars and we want to know. I think victims deserve a say on whether they want to be revealed.
And it's legally contracted for. I mean, honestly, to honor the law and the contract, and it protects both sides.
But do you think that NDAs prolong the problem by silencing
it?
Maybe there might have been things that would come out earlier in a lot of
institutions. Well, no, we know that. That is actually true. Right. Yeah. But that doesn't mean that there couldn't be a victim who would say, I don't want my name out there.
Maybe they don't want that.
Because they signed something.
I think more than anybody, they don't want it out there.
Nobody wants their name out there.
It's not fun or comfortable to come forward or make a complaint.
But prospectively.
But then you have serial abusers who continue because of these NDAs. There were, you could have 5 or 6 NDAs under one guy.
Yes, we know that.
Maybe they didn't want to sign the NDAs either.
Yeah.
They were forced into it.
Yeah. These are important questions that we will continue covering for the next 16 years.